Next slide. We have four product lines in software. We have about 14 key service lines: banking, financial services, insurance, telecom. 14 such key service lines and 14 industry types are there. So the 320,000 people are distributed across these multiple verticals, right? Each is almost an independent company. Like for example, the banking is one vertical, financial services is one vertical, telecom is one vertical. They've got their own business targets, their own customers, right? They are almost like individual companies today. The point is that how do you ensure that knowledge that's created one part of the company is transferred? Although there are 14 different verticals, but they are all part of one single company as at there. The technology is same. If you take about Java or SharePoint or .NET, technology is not going to be different from vertical wise, it's going to be same. So how do people learn and share this across the verticals? That's the topic that I want to talk to you today. Next. Our projects snapshot, there are about 20,000 plus active projects as I'm talking to you today. And the team size varies from one associate, one or two associates, to 1,200 to 1,500 associates. It's a complete different set of demographic-based projects are available. Complexity is very low complexity to medium complexity to high complexity. Any amount of complexity or that you can think of, the world, we execute projects. Now, the reason why I am painting this picture is that you need to, I just want to articulate about why KM is important for a company like TCS, and for that matter, KM is important for anyone, for all of us. Next. If you see, what are the drivers for KM today? Why do we talk about knowledge management today? Is knowledge management something new? No. In fact, I was attending a conference long time ago in Dubai, talking to them about our knowledge management, our KM features, KM applications and all. One of the fellow participants actually whispered in my ear, KM is not new, Shini, you know. Actually, if you really see our scriptures in the very olden days, they were actually passed on. They were not written, they were passed on from one person to another person, but they are still active, alive today. So KM started since those days. KM is not something new. Absolutely, KM is definitely not something new. But it has been changing its shape as the time passed by. So why do we need KM today? What are the business drivers for KM today? Customer expectations. A very simple computation will tell you average TCS count, my organization head count, today it is, let's say, very simple number, 300,000. Last year it was about 280,000, 290,000. So in the last 3 years, if you take the average, we would have delivered about 250,000 into three, about 750,000 man years of work. 750,000 man years of work. Customer is going to tell that you guys have so much of knowledge. How are you guys transferring this knowledge across? So that the productivity of the guy who is developing the software, who is actually providing the service, is improved. That means that the simple question is that the knowledge that you get, the best practices that you learn, the mistake that one person in one project commits, how does it get cascaded across the entire organization so that we don't do that mistake again, we do the good things again. So in essence, the customer is going to tell that, you guys have to deliver more with less. That is the Tarak mantra today. How do you deliver more with less? Every customer is going to ask you, not only our customers, everywhere you go today, wherever you go today, the cost of providing more quality service at a reduced price is going to be really driving that today. That's a customer expectation. And thought leadership. The question that's always invariably being put to us is that you guys have been there in the industry for 47 years, you guys have been doing a lot of projects. What is going to happen in the future? This is my business problem. If you really look at the IT industry, the way how TCA developed also, initially, we actually wrote code for some specifications given by others. That's where we all started. Then we ourselves wrote specifications and then delivered the code based on their business thing. Today, it is the age of business solution for a business problem. Most of my projects today across TCS, what we do today, if the business problem is articulated, then we come up with a business solution. Then corresponding to the business solution, we talk about the hardware, the software, the methodology, the model, the delivery model. Right. So now this is the changing scenario. So how do we demonstrate thought leadership? Knowledge management is very important for that. Accelerated learning. This is extremely important. It's all becoming. I think you're all very young guys, and I can talk to you in your own language. It's all 2020. Everybody talks about 2020 today. Nobody talks about Test cricket today because everybody talks about doing something very fast. You know, I still have people, my neighbors who are saying that very, very old, aged neighbors, 75, 80, 85 years old, they're all coming and telling me, how do we watch Test match, Srini, nowadays? When is the next 2020 coming up? Even 50 over, they don't seem to like nowadays. They all want it very fast, 2020. They say that it's all fantastic, 20 overs, match is gone, very interesting. So the point is accelerated learning. Because in 2020, that you got to learn very quickly. There is nothing like, you know, building a partnership. Have you ever seen a cricket commentator on a TV talking to on a 2020 match, talking about they need to build partnership, play for 10 overs, okay, don't score any run, don't lose wickets? No. Because by the time you close your eyes and open your eyes, 20 overs are gone. Accelerated learning is what everybody talks about today. So gone are the days when we used to take about 90 days, lock students, and the fresh graduates who are fresh recruits into the company, lock them in a classroom, 90 days, 120 days. No, it's all accelerated learning today. So how do we make people, make people learn fast, that knowledge management has come? Innovation, productivity, I've already spoken to you about. Everybody talks about productivity. If I'm going to finish a project, if 10 guys are going to do a project for 3 months and finish it today, we're going to talk about customer says we have no time. You guys have to do it in 6 weeks and with less people. How do we do that? So that means that experience, whatever we have done in many projects has to come in. Somehow has to be stored in some way. And that needs to be leveraged. Next slide. So this is what is the KM scenario today. So next slide. And today it is the age of I change. The generation has changed, the workplace is changing. Right. Everybody talks about changing change today, right? Because the whole Gen Y, everybody talks about Gen X, Gen Y, Gen Z, right? The workplace is completely changing. I don't know how many of you had opportunity to look at some of the old machines that what we used to work, right? And with the green monitor, with the green cursor blinking, today it's all changing. It's all collaborative environment today. We no longer train people. We actually create an ambience for them to learn. Learning is completely different from training. I once attended an IIM training program. It's a pretty exhaustive training program for about 8 days. The first thing that they said is that we don't want to call this as a training program, guys, because we were only there about 10 of us in the room. We don't want to call this a training program, guys. We only train animals. We are all human beings and we learn. So we don't train anyone. So that is the fundamental change paradigm you're talking about today, right? Next slide. So the paradigm today is the world document-centric to user-centric. Completely it is changed today, right? Then we are all talking about an organizational memory. An organization, by virtue of doing so much of work, has created so much of knowledge. And people have to create value out of that knowledge. How do we do that? That's what is KM today. Next. How do we integrate KM with service delivery? See, today, let me tell you something. Today, people don't even want to do a search. They said that, I'm developing my code, let's say in .NET or in SharePoint or in Java or Ruby on Rails, I'm developing my code. If some other project has done a similar project with the same software, same environment, and if they have faced some technology challenges, and if I'm facing similar problem, nobody has the patience even to go and do a search. So what is happening is that organizational memory, something has to be running at the back and pushing that knowledge to the guy who is working, the contextualizing the knowledge. If I'm going to be working on a particular project today, I may not even have time to go and do some search. But the knowledge management system should know that this guy is working on this project. The TCS has already worked in a similar environment in many other projects. The knowledge is available here. So push that knowledge to him, depending on the context, push that knowledge at the doorstep so that this guy can say, there is some knowledge available here. There are people, there are experts on this who have already done that. Would you like to collaborate with them? Would you like to speak with them now? So that is what is really talking about the relevant context at the right time. Because we don't know knowledge that is not knowledge. I mean, initially, about 5 years ago, we were all expecting people to do a search. But today, even that is not there. A search actually is pull technology. Somebody is actually going and doing a search to pull some technology, pull the knowledge. But today, we are all talking about pushing the knowledge. So this is the difference between pull and push. Today, it's all a question of pushing. That push also has to happen with the right context. Otherwise, the consumer will not be able to consume the knowledge. That context comes from the metadata that we are talking, that metadata that we store about the project. Every project that we execute here has got about 80 kinds of metadata that we store. So depending upon the current project, there is a background KM system is going to look for similar engagement and push the data to him. Then it's a question of collaborating with the right guy. There are only two problems in this world as far as I'm concerned. One is expert, other is expertise. Who are the experts who are available in a particular technology or a particular domain, particular area? That's problem number one. Problem number two is, where is the expertise available? So if I sum up for all of you also that, you know, you may, I still remember, all of you remember your maths topic. So if somebody wants to know that real analysis, who are the experts in your college? Do you know how to talk to them? If somebody wants to know who are the complex analysis guys, right, who are the top experts in complex analysis who can solve the 5-year-old problem, and all, you should know. But today, do you know who are those good guys? So translate that into my context, I would say, who are the guys who are good in SharePoint, who can build knowledge management system? So this is exactly the context-based knowledge we are talking about. Next. So KM integrated in the future workplace. I am not sure whether you'll be able to see it from the distance. The point he talks about my project, my performance, right, my workplace, and connected with this, who are the other guys who have similar knowledge, who have worked in similar environment, can I access them, how do I access them? All these things are programmed using KM concepts at the back. Next. The other thing is I learn. The classroom things will slowly go away. This is what we are planning. About 3 years or 4 years ago, it is 80% classroom and 20% virtual. But actually today, it is 90% virtual and 10% classroom there. And 90% virtual is that we actually put some training packages, self-learning training material, and we tell our colleagues that this training material is available. As far as you are all concerned, you are supposed to finish your acquire competency in these areas. So here are the courses, the curriculum is available, do that, and here is the quiz. The quizzes are all stored in a platform called MindWalk, about which I'm going to talk to you. Just go and finish that and come back there. So no, there is no classroom. That doesn't mean the help is not going to be available. Help will be available, made available, but the classroom things will go away. Because the point is, there is nothing like teaching or training today. It's all self-learning. This is a complete paradigm shift in knowledge management today. Yeah. So KM is integrated with, next one, competency building. So we don't talk about skills today, we talk about competency. Because skills, knowledge, skills, attributes, everything is going to be becoming part of competency today. So if any particular project we are going to execute, that project involves certain technology aspect, technology things, item 1, item 2, item 3. Right, then we know that somebody has to acquire competency in Java, somebody has to acquire competency in SQL Server database, and he has to acquire a competency of E2 or E3 at a higher level. Just go and get that competency, build that competency.